like sand. You may be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman, Paul and Brittany, in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God, and signified unto us the mystical union that exists between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons come now to be joined. Paul and Brittany, I charge you both as you stand in the presence of God to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy home. If the solemn vows you are about to make are kept faithfully, and if steadfast you endeavor to be the will of your Heavenly Father, your life will be full of joy. God will bless your marriage, and the home you are establishing will abide in peace. No other ties are more tender, no other vows more sacred than those that you now assume. Paul, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only to her so long as you both shall live? Brittany, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only to him, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Let us pray. Eternal God, the creator and preserver of all of life, the author of salvation and the giver of all grace, Lord, we ask that you would bless and sanctify with your Holy Spirit Paul and Brittany, who come now to join in marriage. Grant that they may give their vows to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Enable them to grow in love and peace with you and with one another all their days, that they may reach out in concern and service to the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
I, Paul, thank you, Brittany.
I, Paul, thank you, Brittany.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I pledge you my faith.
I pledge you my faith.
I, Brittany, take you, Paul.
I, Brittany, take you, Paul.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto. I pledge you my faith.
I pledge you my faith.
The ring. The ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the united of this man and this woman in holy matrimony, to the Church of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us pray. Bless the Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in your peace and continue in your faith through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In token and pledge,
in token and pledge,
of our constant faith,
of our constant faith,
and abiding love,
and abiding love,
with this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed,
I thee wed.
In token and pledge,
in token and pledge,
of our constant faith,
of our constant faith,
and abiding love,
and abiding love,
with this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed. As a sign of their love and a symbol of their unity, given them through the love of Christ our Lord, Paul and Brittany will now light the unity candle. Much as Paul and Brittany have considered together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Let us pray. Father, we know that you are the creator and preserver of us all. And Lord, we ask that you would send your blessings upon Paul and Brittany, whom we bless in your name, that they may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them made, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to your law. Lord, look graciously upon them, that they may love, honor, and cherish each other, and so live together in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessings and a place of peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Paul and Brittany, may God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, may he bless, preserve, and keep you. May he graciously, with his favor, look upon you, and so fill you with all spiritual benediction and love, that you may so live together in this life, that in the world to come may have life and life.
Amen. 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 Amen.
my pleasure to be the first to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Paul Wyatt.
I really couldn't honestly tell you, but after that night, the bickering, loving, laughing, arguing, protectiveness that we had started and never stopped. And Paul, through the Sigma Chi fraternity, meeting him and living with him were the best, and TJ, living with him and TJ, were the best 2 years of my life. I can honestly say that I've been blessed to be a part of their lives. And so I really don't have much to say other than I have one small bit of advice. And although I am a rookie in marriage of only 2 years right now, my lovely wife, Kaylee, I think even the veterans in the crowd would agree with my small bit of advice. If you find yourself, if and when you ever have what you consider a serious disagreement, if you find yourself in that proverbial web of arguing,
the spider.
Don't do that arguing. Go for the spider. And what do I mean by that? Go for the root cause, and that is communication, because, or lack thereof, because through good communication, and God is your guide, you're going to have the most bountiful and beautiful of marriages. And so, I don't want to keep this winded. And I would like to make a toast to Paul and Brittany. May they have the happiest of marriages, the fewest of disagreements, and the most abundant number of babies. Paul and Brittany.
All right, so for those of y'all who don't know me, I'm Abby, and I'm one of Brittany's maids of honor. Now, I haven't known Brittany my whole entire life, but I have known her a long time. We met in high school, where we bonded over our mutual nerdiness and our daydreams. We dreamed of traveling to faraway places and having grand romances. And we would eventually move into twin mansions with a secret tunnel connecting them. Now here we are. Brittany found her Prince Charming, Paul. And he's from Paris. Not France, but it's close enough to our teenage dreams. So while I was writing my speech, I thought for a while about comparing Brittany to a Disney princess today, because she's as beautiful as one. But as I was going through the list of princesses in my head, I realized that none of them have best friends. Well, they do, but they're mice, or they're fish, or they're a raccoon. And I was like, why do none of the princesses have a human best friend? And then I realized that a human best friend would annoy the prince. With warnings that he better not hurt the princess, Paul, barging in on date nights, even insisting on being part of the proposal. I mean, human best friends are a nuisance to the prince. But Paul has graciously put up with me. There's a silly rule on the internet, and it says that if you've been friends for 7 years, you will be friends for life. Brittany and I have reached that 7-year mark. So, Paul, you might not have known this, but a few hours ago, when you married Brittany, you also guaranteed that I will be in your life forever. Sorry about that. You might also have to build a mansion that connects to mine one day. So be prepared. All right. But still, Paul, you're truly the luckiest man alive today because you get to go home with a beautiful bride. And more importantly, you get to hang out with her every day. And she's going to love you forever. And as someone who loves Brittany and who knows her so well, I know that you will have someone to share everything with. Brittany has given me a shoulder to cry on. She has brightened my life with her jokes and her happiness. And she has helped me think through any problem to find the best solution. She is my best friend. And I know that she will do all those things for you. So as I was writing this speech, I was talking to my mom about how to wrap up the speech because I have no idea. And she... I eventually chose my own ending, but I thought everyone should know what she told me. I was talking to her this morning, and she looked up to the sky and said, "How about something like this? The end." But I thought of something a little more fitting, so if you will all raise a glass with me, I would like to toast to Brittany and Paul and to happily ever after.